closed casket, which in French is called La Mort à ses raisons, is my second Poirot novel. And it starts when Poirot and his sidekick, Inspector Edward Catchpole, are invited to a house party by a famous novelist. She's a famous writer for children. And at dinner, on the first night that they're there, this famous writer, whose name is Lady Playford, announces that she's changed her will and she's left all her money to her secretary, who only has a few weeks to live. Meanwhile, her two children have been cut off without a penny. So it's a big sort of controversial announcement. And Poirot and Catchpole don't know why they've been invited. They don't know any of these people. So they've been invited sort of as strangers. And Poirot works out that they must have been invited because Lady Playford expects somebody to commit a murder after she makes this announcement. And sure enough, there is a murder, but it's not of the person Poirot thought it was going to be. So can he solve the mystery before anyone else gets killed? That's the premise. I started completely from scratch, so the only element that was invented by Agatha Christie is Poirot. All the other characters and the plot and the setting and everything is my creation. Although obviously Agatha, as well as inventing Poirot, also invented the milieu of the Poirot novel. You know, she wrote many novels starring Poirot, and her readers and fans across the world know what a Poirot novel is, and they know what they want and expect from a Poirot novel. So my job was not only to write a book with Poirot in it, but to write a book, two books as I've written now, that's recognisably a Poirot novel. So there has to be a fiendishly puzzling mystery to solve that no one is clever enough to solve except Poirot. And there has to be that nice sort of golden age of detective fiction feel about it. Yeah, I would say the tone and the character of Poirot obviously come from Christie, but no, the rest is my invention. And one thing that I think I picked up from being influenced by Christie at an early age is this thing of starting a crime novel with not just a murder, but something so weird that the reader almost can't believe it's happening. If you think about Christie's novels, so many of them start with a situation that makes you think, why on earth would this ever happen? And you just cannot imagine why it would. It's almost like a surreal element. And so I've tried to do that as well. I'm very attracted to that kind of mystery. And in Closed Casket, I just love the idea of this famous rich woman changing her will to leave everything, which is she has a vast fortune, and she's leaving it all to someone who is definitely or almost definitely going to die long before her. Why would anyone ever do that? So that was, you know, when I thought of that idea, I thought that is a very Agatha-ish, weird, intriguing plot hook for a crime novel. She is the best, most ingenious, and most talented mystery writer that there's ever been. When you start reading an Agatha Christie story, you are literally hooked straight away. You just can't let go, and you don't want to, because she has this brilliant talent of writing stories that are incredibly simple and clearly written. So they hook you in. Even if you're only 12, you can absolutely follow. The writing style is very plain and simple, and it's all about the story and the plot, and she hooks you in with this clarity and simplicity. But at the same time, her books are incredibly intellectually challenging, because you can never solve the puzzle before Poirot or Miss Marple. And I think that is her genius. She blends very, very simple with very, very complex in a way that almost no other writer, I think, does. I think at the moment my favourite is actually Evil Under the Sun, which is one that takes place in a seaside resort, in a hotel by the seaside, and Poirot's on holiday. And it's just brilliant. It's got so many of the things Agatha does so well in it, including the idea that it's very easy. It's easier to commit a murder on holiday than anywhere else, because on holiday, if you want to be somewhere in order to kill someone, you don't have to explain your presence in close proximity to them. You're just there because everyone's there on holiday. And that's such a great idea, you know. And this is what Agatha did time and time again. She was very, very intellectual, actually. She was a very clever woman, and she constantly tried to expand the way in which we think about the detective novel. And she must have realised before writing Evil Under the Sun that no one had had this idea before, that if you're just on holiday with everyone else, you can be very close to your victim, and it seems natural. And it's just a brilliant, brilliant novel. Well as writing Poirot novels, which are set in 1929, 1930, I also write a series of contemporary psychological thrillers, which are set now. And I've actually found, since I started writing the Poirots, it's actually very creatively refreshing to switch between different kinds of writing. I feel that every Poirot novel that I have written so far, I've kind of had a boost of energy because it's such a different challenge from the novel I wrote before, which is a contemporary, quite dark, gritty psychological thriller. And vice versa, if I've just written a golden age mystery starring Poirot, it's quite nice to then immerse myself in a dark psychological thriller set now. And I find that switching between different kinds of writing makes me pay more attention to what I'm doing in both areas. I think otherwise the temptation would be to just write the kind of books you write, and then there's a danger that a writer could get lazy or complacent if they never set themselves a new creative challenge.